What's good, everybody? My name is Sydney Baker Green. I'm an internationally published wedding photographer, content creator, and cinematographer. And today I'm so excited to bring you guys my review of the 1DX Mark II, the holy grail currently of Canon DSLRs. We're gonna look at this camera from both a photography perspective and a cinematography perspective. So without further ado, let's roll my intro and get right into it. So we're talking about Canon's flagship DSLR today. It's a $6,000 camera body, and there's no question to if this camera is not a beast. Because let's be honest, we all know what it is, that's why we talk about it. But I wanna give you guys a real world view of this camera after extensively using it on weddings, using it to create travel videos, creating content for businesses, and just taking it around the world with me. So let's get right into it, and let's talk about some of the pros and cons of this camera. The most important thing to a photographer is how does the camera perform? Starting with low light performance, this is a huge pro with this camera. My previous body was the 5D Mark III, and personally, I felt like that body was amazing when it came to low light capabilities. There still would be times though I knew I needed a flash at a wedding. I would never go into a low light situation without a flash if I'm getting paid, especially a lot of money for that gig. My past wedding in January, I went out to California, and I shot this wedding without a flash in a very dark venue. And I have to say, I was able to get some amazing photos, easily pushing ISO 12,800 and ISO 3200. And I got some amazing images for my artistic style at least. Now, the 1DX Mark II is actually renowned for its weatherproofing. And I have to say, although the 5D Mark IV is weatherproof and so is the 5D Mark III, the body you see the people out in National Geographic using is definitely the Canon 1DX Mark II. And that is simply because, again, the power to create. There's no better feeling than being out in the rain with your Ronin-S, your 1DX, and your weather-sealed gear, and just feeling at ease because you know the manufacturer did such a great job of protecting the body. I've used it out in the rain so many times. My camera goes swimming more than I do, and I'm in a water sport. So it's just an amazing at-ease feeling and a great thing to, again, keep you in sync with your gear and focus on the creativity. Now, one of the things that I did not like in the performance category is the fact that this camera uses CFast cards. Now, if you don't know what CFast is, it's basically an SSD for your camera, and it's also just as expensive as an SSDs are cheaper than CFast cards. A 128GB CFast card, I believe, cost anywhere from about $300 to $500. And you know, that's just a ballpark range from what I saw on Amazon. These cards are needed because the motion JPEG codec on the 1DX Mark II is a huge file size. Period. I would shoot maybe a 10-minute video for YouTube and I would get a 10GB file or something like that. So that's just one thing you're really gonna wanna keep in mind when you're buying this camera, is that if you really wanna push the 4K aspect of your video production, then you are going to need a CFast card. Now, there is a way around this, and stay tuned on my video for how to properly format your CF cards, because I use a compact flash card by ProMaster that shoots at about 90 megabits per second. And if I format it correctly, if I format it on my computer, I am able to shoot 1080p at 120 FPS easily and for a limited amount of time, enough to make at least a 10 to 15 minute YouTube video, I can shoot in 4K at 25 FPS. Now, as much as we love our 4K, I would have to say another con is the fact that 4K is cropped on this camera. Now, the crop factor in 4K is not as bad as the ESR, and it's not as bad as the 5D Mark IV. However, it is still a crop factor, so I cannot shoot with my 35mm prime, which is the widest prime I have. Fortunately, I do have my 16-35 f2.8L Mark III lens, so I can throw that on if I really want to shoot 4K. However, I do lose the sharpness of my prime lenses, but that's only because I don't personally own a super wide angle prime. So this could be a pro for you or it could be a con for you depending on the situation that you have with the camera. But don't get me wrong, those aren't enough to really deter me from this camera because everything else just shines. Another thing I love about this camera is the dual pixel autofocus system. In photo, this camera puts me at ease. Shooting with this camera, especially at a wedding, a high-paced event where you cannot miss a moment, it really puts me at ease to know that I don't have to worry about my autofocus system hitting a tack sharp focus 99.9% of the time. The dual pixel 8F system on the 1D X Mark II feels buffed up compared to what I saw on the 5D Mark IV and any other dual pixel 8F camera that I've used. Even shooting through the viewfinder, I'm able to find the faces of my subject and move with them at a shallow f-stop such as 1.4 and not miss focus, which to me is amazing. The focus system gives you a true power to create. On top of that focus system, coupled with the 14 frames per second burst rate, this thing is an Uzi and it does not miss. Fast moving subjects for me most of the time were always in focus. I have found myself throwing out a lot less photos due to focus issues coming from the 5D Mark III using the 1D X Mark II. In video, again, the focus system just blows it out of the water. Being able to shoot and track my subjects really allows me to dive into how I like to shoot, which is run and gun. Now, if you're a true cinematographer, or quotations on true professional cinematographer, because that's subjective, you know they're gonna say, you know, Sid, we use follow focuses, and while this is true, I personally think that is greater than or equal to the most. Seriously. I mean, there's great moments when you can use it, but if you're out just creating content like we do or anything like that, it's really not that necessary. So with that being said, the focus system and the burst rate of this camera really gives you the power to create anything you want to do. And it's going to allow you to feel at ease in synchronization with your gear. And with that, you are able to create better content because you're focusing on the creativity and less on the performance of your gear. Now, to me, my personal favorite thing, my winning factor, is the color science of this camera. And you know, Fuji and Canon really have the lock on color science. I will give Nikon, they do have a lock on the photo side at least. Dynamic range. I shoot with the C-Log profile made by James Miller, and if you expose correctly, you are going to get a great image. Color grading the images on from this camera are simply amazing. Even when using more creative LUTs and looks, you are able to get a style that's just creamy skin tones, and you don't have to mess around with those skin tones as long as you hit your exposure. If you don't hit your exposure, it's gonna get mucky and it's gonna be really hard to correct those skin tones. But if you get your exposure right, which becomes easy over time as you use the camera, then you're gonna be so much at ease when you go through post-production. Anyway, guys, that is my short and sweet YouTube video on really my review of the 1D X Mark II, how I feel it performs in the field, and why I feel, honestly, this is still the best camera to get in 2019. I know they're coming out with tons of iterations. The ESR, for me, just wasn't it. The A7 Mark III just ain't it. They got the better color profiles, okay, but if you're looking for a camera that does photo and both photo and video well and performs amazing and you have the budget to get it, then the 1D X Mark II is it. So let's go ahead and I'm gonna give you my final verdict. What do I think about all this? Who needs this camera? Because let's be honest, $6,000. And a lot of us out here, we got gear envy. We're all out here saying, oh, well, this is the gear Peter McKinnon uses and Maddie uses, but what do you need? I am the type that values production cost because it adds value to my services. And I'm also the type that likes to do everything well. And that's what this camera does. It does photo well. It does 120 FPS slow motion well, and it looks great. And that's what matters the most to me. Does it look great? Yes, you can get this on similar bodies, but if those are the things that are important to you, and you can also justify, you know, using gear like that, you know, are you gonna use it to the extent that I do? Do you shoot 20 weddings a year? Are you traveling the world making videos? Do you need gear that can keep up and not miss a moment? Or are you sitting at home making YouTube videos? If you're sitting at home just making YouTube videos, trying to start a YouTube channel, this camera ain't for you. But if you're actually making a career out of photography and you want the best of the best to do what you do, then the 1D X Mark II, currently in 2019 in the first quarter, is still the best camera to get. Easily over the Sony A7 Mark III, and yeah, it can keep up, but honey, we all know it ain't the 1D X Mark II. So, I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, be sure to give me a big thumbs up. Go ahead and share it with a friend who needs to hear it. And if you're new here, smash that subscribe button because I'm trying to get to 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year. And more importantly, I'm trying to beat Will, our friend Bug Visuals, before I do it because we all know I'm gonna whoop his anyway. Again, guys, you know I love you guys. Will's link is in the description down below. And as always, follow me on my social media. And remember, every day, airplanes take off against the wind. Live, love, laugh, stay inspired, and stay fabulous. My name is Sydney. I'll see you guys on Sunday, and I hope you like coffee. Peace out.